Hello and good morning, everybody. My name is Jim Woodrick and I am the Great Lakes Realtor and I service Michigan. Today on my Google Analytics search, I want to share with you Michigan buy-sell agreements, and I'm going to kind of deep dive. I don't want to bore you too much because this is going to be a very boring talk. Not everybody likes to talk about contracts, but before I get started, I want to say I'm not a legal attorney, so I can't give you legal advice. The only thing I can do is help you understand and explain these contracts to you, the two that we use. Now, Google Analytics is very vague. It's not very detailed, so it basically just shows what is the highest searched topic within said topic. So in my case, my topic was real estate. Who is talking about real estate? So everybody wants to know what Michigan buy-sell agreements are, or they want to know where to get them. So my best and strongest bit of advice is if you want to get a copy, reach out to your local real estate agent. Now, I want you to be aware that every agreement is going to be different by association. So in the great state of Michigan here, for example, we have several different contract types for every association. One for Kalamazoo, one for Battle Creek area, we got one for Detroit and Lansing area, and then we have one here for the Grand Rapids area. So do be aware of those. Every one is going to be different, and as far as terms and details and those little things, but there are also very large similarities between the contracts. One obviously caters to the buyers, one obviously caters to the seller, and you go from there. All right. So I'm not trying to be disrespectful, but I'm going to make it very short, sweet, and simple. So grab your soda pop and join in with me before I switch over to my screen. Now, remember, you can find me on all three of those social media platforms that I mentioned at the beginning of this video. So if you have any questions or there's something that I did not explain or go into detail, very well, then I want you to reach out and ask me those things. All right. So I hope that helps. I know contracts are not the greatest thing in the world. They're pretty boring, I'm not gonna lie. But I figured I would give you an in-depth little crash course on them. So let me know if I missed anything. If there's something out there that I misinterpreted, I would love to re-share that with you and go into more detail. But other than that, buying and selling is pretty easy. That's what your real estate agent is there for. Those forms are long and lengthy and complicated. There's a lot of detail. And I didn't go in and go real in depth with those forms, but you want to pay attention to them. Like I said, if you want to get copies of those forms, reach out to any real estate agent within your area. If you can't find anybody, give me a shout on Facebook, TikTok, YouTube. And I will get those too. But other than that, I hope you found it informational, educational, and I hope it helps you better understand what's going on with those agreements. If you want to get more in depth into the legality, I would highly recommend you reach out to not just any attorney, but a real estate attorney. And they can help educate you on what's going on in a transaction and those sorts of things. I would always have one in your back pocket. And just for learning and knowledge and education purposes, I wouldn't go around just trying to sue everybody, you know. But like, say there's something fishy going on and you don't understand, like, you can talk to a real estate agent, you can talk to an attorney. Those people will share their knowledge with you. But other than that, you guys have a beautiful day. You have a great day and enjoy it.